Don't you love it when making brake lines just comes out perfect? Welcome to, I guess, the 16th video of this car. If you guys have struck an interest in this, there is 15 other videos that we have on this, so there's quite a lot of stuff going on with it. First part of it was actually how we got the car here. He was recommended to us by another shop who we know. He went to them seeing if they would take on the project. They didn't want to at the time. He called us. We decided that we wanted to. And when he brought the car, that was a different thing. It was not what we expected for what he was talking about doing. So he wanted a show car, built, turbo, H-series, all this other stuff, right? And it shows up. And the car looks like it actually looked worse than some of the cars I've seen at the junkyard. And I'm not lying about that. We have footage. You can go see. It was pretty rough. The transmission was just sitting in it. Just the transmission. Things were kind of thrown about. There was just bolts everywhere. I'm pretty sure it might have lost at least several bolts on the trip over here with the tow truck driver. And then we get it. And we're like, okay, this is definitely not what we were expecting. So we start going through the parts that he brings and everything is nice, which doesn't add up. And so it just kind of is one of those things of, okay, was it the other shop that it came from, which was, it was either a shop or some guy in his backyard. I don't know. I honestly couldn't tell the difference. So we start looking at the parts and there's a map sleeved block for the H23. We're like, okay, this guy actually cares about this and actually will spend money on the entire thing. I don't know why the project hadn't gone anywhere. So we started building the block. We started putting everything together. We started getting everything mounted. And it was one of those things where we were still kind of new in our shop. So we were still, you know, having to do other work and we couldn't just sit and focus on this car, which luckily now in the past two or so months, I've actually been able to get that side of the shop happy and I've been able to spend time over here, which is why we're able to do these videos. So in that, everything that we do for this is pretty much custom. There's not much of this that we want to do or even in our mind that we're thinking of what we want to do that is just an off-the-shelf part, which is cool and it takes forever for us to make. So that's one reason why this is taking a while. The other reason is just stuff going on with the shop, and I can only thank the owner of the car that he's been patient and he will wait and he's happy with what we do. I've also been learning stuff with this car. So the fabrication stuff that I did with this, learning how to make it in a CAD program, the 3D printing stuff was in the meantime while we were doing this. I had to learn how to do all that. And even bending the brake lines and stuff, I kind of, you know, was learning as we were doing all of this. So not only has this been a really fun car to see it come to the point that it's at right now, but it's been a really fun car because I've just been able to learn new things. This is one of those things where it's a labor of love. And one, I know I'm going to love it when it's done. I hope that you guys love it when it's done just because it's nice to have people like what you do. Once we're done with it and we have everything ready to go, we used to have a paint booth. We don't anymore. So I'm going to help him find a painter so that we can get this thing done the way that we were talking about. And I'll pull everything out of the engine bay that we have to pull out, this and that. That way everything's good to go and I can put it back in after the painter's done with it. That's just another hurdle we're going to have to come over. So I'm throwing in the fittings that are going to be moving from the compressor to the lines that we're going to be putting on this, the ones that we got to make. We're going to move forward on this thing and, you know, continue working on it. So the AC lines are kind of my next focus. And this is one of those things where I got to try and see how I want to run them, what direction I want them to go, and, you know, where everything's going to be sitting in the car. Okay. I don't know. Are we going to use these ones? We might use these ones. So they're not going to fit perfect because I'm not going to use the O-rings currently. But why do everything proper when I don't know how it's going to work? Running over this and making sure I know, okay, like, you know, that line goes to there, this line goes here, and this is how all of it's going, right? Another thing that I realized of why this project takes a while and I'm learning and, you know, so on and so forth, and I haven't done this a whole lot, is I order stuff and then I realize I have to order more stuff. We have the AC lines coming out here. I'm thinking either I'm going to find 180 degree bends, that way they go down more, or 135 degree bends so that they bend down a little bit, but not, you know, straight down, just because I decided to grab some hose and we're just gonna shove it on there so we can see how this would run if we used the 90 degrees. I could have swore that I got some 45 degree bends with this as well. I did not. So that goes in there. Because this one is going to go to this, so that actually works out. That line might be perfectly fine the way that it is. Yeah, so this is pointing straight at the body here, which, you know, isn't the end of the world, but would be nicer. And if this was pointing down, then I could have a hose kind of bend there, or any other stuff. You know, I could have like a 60 degree bend and it go through this line, the two 90s here. And it's the other thing too, it's either a 90 or a straight that I have. So either it comes straight up or it goes the way that it is. So either way, it's not going to be going the way that I want it to. And then I'm just gonna see, I mean, you can already kind of tell that the bigger hose is no bueno on that. Yeah, I don't know how. So we got the oil cooler lines there. That's not gonna work there. All right. So, this is a common theme with what we've been doing. However, most of the time that we do stuff like this or find these problems, we didn't film it for you guys. So you didn't get to see our struggles, but now you get to. I'm gonna try to run more of this. That way I have an idea of everything I need to order. And then hopefully I get it sometime this week and we can continue with that. Once I figure out what I need to order, we're not dead in the water anymore. Trying to figure out how I want to run this. Making a bracket to put it over here keeps it out of the way. I ran it under the radiator. That way I could try that. And now I'm checking it over the radiator and I put it up underneath the core support kind of thing. Where the hood latch used to be, I ran it under that. And I'm kind of liking that. However, I still have to mount the receiver dryer. And either I come up with a cool little mounting point for it so that it can sit like right here, or I try to hide it somewhere, which may or may not work. Now, where I'm at right now is I'm like, okay, well, I see how this works, but I want to see if maybe I can put it up here. But I need to make sure that this intake tube and so on and so forth are good, which means the intake manifold has to be on and so on and so forth. You know, I can do a stock Honda thing, which is kind of like you have it like mounted under something like this, so you can't really see it that much. But I want to put the reservoir for this over here or somewhere. So now I have to put stuff together and I have to design something completely different that I'm not doing right now so that I can continue the project that I originally started. Stuff that's the old bracket for the intercooler, which I'm going to remake. I put everything back in with the intercooler and the pipes and the intake manifold and found out with the rear mount in there, the intake manifold hits the black part of the mount or the bracket that goes to the transmission. So with that, I'm probably going to see if Hasport offers a redone one. That way I just don't have to do anything and we can buy theirs and put it in and be done with it. If not, I'll have to remake one that so that it clears better, because I don't like the grinded look. I just wanted it to fit for right now. And then I'm going to start making the reservoir for the water for this, and I have a pump picked out for it and everything like that. I don't know if we'll get to it this time, but I did change my mind on the heater core. So I think we're going to keep coolant going through it, but I have an idea to change it and still make it seem cool. And then my brake line. So the last one that I did, everything came out great. I got it hooked onto the ABS pump. It looked beautiful. I come to this side to screw it in and, well, you heard. Not happy. So what I'm going to do with that is on the bracket that holds the rubber one, since we're like 3/4 of an inch too short, I'm going to drill the spot welds and we'll move that back up. So I don't have to remake the line. I just have to weld the bracket back on where I want it to be. Bracket number one done, because I'm actually going to turn it from being a giant bracket into two little ones. That one was the easiest one for me to make. I just have it going from the one mount there, or the one mount on the intercooler, to the one bolt that I was using for the old mount as well. Definitely not easy to see. I wanted to get made out of cardboard like I always do. And then I'm actually going to do these ones out of steel. So I'll probably do stainless, that way it's kind of prettier. I want to make them out of steel, that way they can be small and still be strong. The next one, I'm probably just going to do on the lower one because there's three of these. So I'm probably not going to use this mount, which most likely, just because, you know, show car stuff, it has to look pretty. I might shave that mount off and then we'll have to do a polish or whatever again on it and use the one under here. And I'll probably still go back to the same mounts that I did under the starter, but that one's going to be maybe not more complicated, but we'll see what I come up with. So I got my second cardboard done. It's down here off the front of it. I'm using the same bracket that I used to bolt it up last time. I just have it coming to the front on the lower one. And since they'll be out of stainless steel, it's definitely gonna be much stronger. Next thing we gotta do actually is take these off. I'm gonna go see my friend Dave. We're gonna go make the stuff on his CAD program, because he actually paid for his CAD program and mine's free. So they don't really work together. And I have my CRX thing, so I'm gonna do that as well while we're over there. We've been over here before and I've done some stuff, and I just wanted to show you what goes on in my mind. So this is that. That's the best way I can put it. This is how Dave taught me. It's not for everybody. That's kind of how I drew this. That's the end of it. And now I'm going to do the quick trim and get rid of all the lines I don't want. At the point of tacking everything together. So I got this one tacked, the one that's way down here that you can't see. And then I have to go over to the one that's down here that you can't see and tack that one together. And then I'm gonna take it all off, go over to the table. And I have an idea one of my buddies had mentioned in a while ago of how to like back purge something that's open. I'm gonna try to do that to not have some ugly welds going on there and do at least a decent looking weld for right now. I've got them tacked together, and what I was talking about was setting them up so that I don't have any ugliness. So this is, you know, normal weld. It's got all the shielding gas around it, and this is what happens on the other side. So we don't like that. That don't look good. So I have an idea where I'm going to take this hose, and I can have gas come out of this hose. There's a few other options to do it where it comes out a little bit nicer or whatever, but I'm going to try and get gas spraying at the back of this or at the back under here. That way, as I weld it, there's also gas hitting the back, because this is unshielded welding. And again, that's shielded welding. So we don't want any of this ugliness. We got to try to remedy that. turn off the welder and the gas, but we're gonna see if my concoction or whatever this you wanna call this has worked. Actually, it doesn't even look like I got all the way through, which I'm okay with, because then I can just do a weld on the back and we should be more than fine. Everything stayed okay, but our little ugly bit stayed there and we didn't get any more ugly bit even on the little corner here where I wrapped around a little bit, as you can see. I'm okay with that. I'll just do some on the back and kind of do a full wrap on that, and then that should be more than strong enough to hold up the intercooler, but we're gonna do the second one just cause. I got them welded. I am happy with how it came out. I didn't have any of those weird unshielded welds going on. I got that one sitting in there already. So we're gonna put them on. Intercooler is done and mounted. The next thing, right, there's still some stuff that we have ordered, but I was looking at it and I text Brian from Hasport about the rear mount. You know, do I have to make a new one? Does he make one? Whatever. And I sent him a picture and I was like, did you make one? Because I only saw one for a different year. And he said, yes. And I sent him a picture of underneath where I had the clearance and stuff. And I said, will it clear this? And he said, nope. So we were talking and I was like, well, I guess I'll have to make my own little bracket. And he was like, or you could rotate the throttle body. And I was like, well, there's something I didn't think about, which I have this spacer from Junk 2, and it bolts onto the K-Series manifold, and then these bolt onto the spacer, and that's where we're getting that little twist, and this is going straight into the motor mount. So I've been spending some time with my little Tinkercad, the free stuff, and so I have that. I'm going to make some little steps for the lower bolts that are going to go into the intake manifold, and then we're going to test this, and then I'll make it prettier, but I need to know if it'll actually work for one. So wish me luck. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Do all that stuff. There's definitely a lot more of the Prelude coming, and then we have more projects to go.